Welcome to online lecture series of subject turbo machines. So here is a Professor Lakshman Mani. This is a lecture on introduction to turbo machinery. I acknowledge my sincere thanks for the using references for getting the basic concepts to make this video. By studying this session, you will be able to explain hydraulic and thermal machines, positive displacement machines, comparison between positive displacement machines and turbo machines, classification of turbo machines, types of flow, fundamental equation governing turbo machines, losses and applications of turbo machine. Let us see positive displacement machines. Positive displacement machine in which the transfer of energy to the fluid is done by squeezing action. For example, here is a reciprocating pump. As the plunger moves in forward direction, energy is transferred to the fluid, thus pressure of the fluid is increased. In this case, inlet valve and outlet valve are not open simultaneously. During the suction, inlet valve is open, fluid is taken inside. In forward stroke of the plunger, inlet valve is closed. When the sufficient pressure is developed, outlet valve is open and fluid at high pressure is delivered. So in this case, no leakage between suction and delivery, and flow is not continuous, that is intermittent. Second example of positive displacement machines is here. Here is a gear pump. So in this case, fluid as a oil is taken on suction side. This oil is trapped between the gear tooth and casing. As it moves in forward direction, pressure is increased. So high pressurized fluid is coming out. So here, physical barrier between gears and casing is very important. By the relative motion between gear and casing, the pressure is developed. So in this case also, there are no valves. Now about turbo machines. Now turbo, meaning of turbo is move around, means about the axis. So we can take here one example for the better understanding. So this is a centrifugal pump. The part which rotates is called as impeller. So here it has action on the fluid. So energy transfer is taking place by dynamic action between the fluid and moving blades. So here no mechanical barrier between inlet and outlet. So in this case, no valves at the inlet and outlet. So flow is continuous. General parts of turbo machines. Turbo machine consists following parts. Number one, shaft. If you see this image, this is the central part, is called a shaft, on which this rotary element called as rotor impeller is mounted, which consists of number of blades or vanes. This is housing part on which blades are fixed. These are called as stator. These are fixed blades. This casing is especially of volute type, means cross-sectional area of this is varying in forward direction. The fluid enters via inlet pipe to the machine while it goes out via outlet pipe. Classification of turbo machines. Turbo machines are classified based on various categories. As far as type of action is concerned, they are classified as impulse turbine and reaction turbine. As per the type of flow direction, these are classified as tangential flow, radial flow, axial flow turbo machines. As far as energy transfer is concerned, they are classified as power producing and power absorbing. And type of fluid, they are classified as hydraulic turbo machines and thermal turbo machines. Let us see in detail. Power producing turbo machines means these turbo machines are used to produce the power, to generate the power. So for example, turbines, in that hydraulic turbines. So these are three types: Beltonville, Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine. Now in this turbine, fluid is used as a water. While the fluid is used as a steam, then it is steam turbine. Power absorbing turbo machine means these turbo machines are run by using electrical energy. So here is electrical energy input. By using a prime mover like electrical motor, these turbo machines are rotated. For example, pumps and compressors, centrifugal pump, centrifugal compressor, axial compressor. Now, depending on type of action, impulse turbine. In case of impulse turbine, the basic difference between impulse and reaction is what? That we'll see here. So, energy which is available at this point, at the inlet of turbine, that is total energy, is kinetic energy. So, at the instant when this jet strikes to the bucket, whole conversion of kinetic energy into mechanical energy takes place. That's why this turbine is called as impulse turbine. So this is invented by Pelton, that's why it is also called as Pelton wheel. Now we will come to the point, reaction turbines. In case of reaction turbine, total energy available at the inlet of turbine is kinetic and pressure energy. So here, when the fluid enters, it will go to the stator, means fixed blade, where partial conversion of potential energy and kinetic energy into mechanical energy take place. These are also called as guide vanes. Now, when the fluid is passing ahead and it comes to the runner, passes through the moving vane, their remaining conversion of potential energy and kinetic energy into mechanical energy is taking place. So that is the principle of reaction turbine. So this is Francis turbine, which is invented by the Francis. Now, based on flow, tangential flow turbine, here this is the Pelton wheel where the jet is striking to the bucket tangential. In case of radial flow, if you see this animation, it is a centrifugal compressor. The fluid is entering, it may be air, it is entering along the axis here at the eye, and then it is moving along the radial direction, in outward direction. So that's why this kind of flow is radial flow. Another example is centrifugal pump, in which fluid is entering via inlet pipe at the eye, then it is moving in a radial direction on the blades. That's why it is coming under the radial flow turbo machine. Now, in this case, mechanical energy is converted into pressure energy, because specifically these turbo machines are used to produce the high pressurized fluid. Centrifugal pump for getting high pressurized water, while centrifugal compressor is used for getting high pressurized air. In case of mixed flow turbo machine, the flow is of two types. So fluid is entering to the impeller in a radial direction, while it is leaving the runner in axial direction. So if you see here animation, fluid is entering radially through the vanes and it is coming out in axial direction of the rotor or impeller. Example of mixed flow is Francis turbine. One more example of axial flow is axial flow compressor, in which air is passing along the direction of axis of rotating this shaft. Now on this, number of series of blades are mounted, so it passes through the stator, then the moving blades in axial direction. In case of steam turbine also, the flow is axial. If you see here, it is nozzle which is injecting a steam on the stator blades, then it is passing to the moving blade disc. So here is a flow in parallel to the axis of shaft. Likewise, in case of water turbine, as a Kaplan turbine, the water flow inside the runner is along the direction of axis of the shaft. That's why it is also axial flow turbo machine. Now, in turbo machine, to calculate the force exerted by a fluid on the blade or on the vane, impulse momentum principle is used. What is it? It is a rate of change of momentum. So force exerted by the fluid on the vane is rate of change of its momentum. So it is based on Newton's second law. So how it can be written? Force is equal to mass flow rate, that is in kg per second, because here we use as a water, so kg per second means for the gas. Okay, mass flow rate into velocity difference. So here are two velocities, v1 is a velocity before striking and v2 is velocity after striking the blade. Now in case of turbo machines, different losses are, which are because of leakage, friction. Some losses occurs at exit, some losses occurs in bearing. So that's why, as compared to output power, input power, output power is less. So efficiency is calculated by using formula output power divided by input power. Now, applications of turbo machines, already we have discussed about water turbines, steam turbines, centrifugal pumps, centrifugal compressor, axial compressors. Now, fans and blowers are turbo machines which are working at low pressure. So, main objective of these two turbo machines is to circulate the required quantity, discharge of air at required place. So, normally these turbo machines, you can see here, these are fans, this is the blower. These are used in air conditioning system to convey the conditioned air from one place to the room or to the conditioned space. So after studying this session, you can illustrate different classes of turbo machines, different types of flow. You can describe the positive displacement machine, can explain difference between positive displacement machine and turbo machine, can illustrate different losses in turbo machines and applications of turbo machine. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.